Peggy. How you doing, Peggy? You out there looking at this movie? What's up?
Cell phone drink, fucking black and jersey, calling Santa Monica. Sporatic, Sunjam, his name's Porky. And we also got a new percussionist.
Thank you. Oh,
Thank you. You guys are awesome. Thank you all.
Love you, Davey.
Thank you guys for putting this together. Sunrider Nod, State Fair, Linantud, Riot. We'd like to bring some friends up. Dee, Shannon, and Jen. And the cancel stamps. And the cancel stamps. And so, can we put them on?
Everyone's welcome to share.
Be careful over there.
But I wouldn't get too close.
Does that include me, Joe? I want to share you.
Oh, you're something, dog. I see that all the ladies stay to the other side of the stage. I see. Oh, I love you too. Smart, but disappointing.
This is, I think this is one of the best songs ever written, to be honest with you. There's so many of them you can say it about, but this one is for Cass. And when I was like, God, where'd y'all record that?
Where'd y'all record that song?
It's incredible. The horns he gets and you gotta hear it.
What are you about to?
Oh, yeah.
Social service, that makes sense.
That was Mount Royal, yeah.
This is the cast, this is called the song for Cat. Thank you. strength, you guys. And Porky! Thank you so much, Porky!
I think Sunjam just became two drummer band. We got a couple more for ya. Just gotta switch guitars over.
Just
social! Thanks everybody for coming out tonight and, you know, to support me. And we got a special treat. Dave's nephew's here. And one of the bands are changing. He's going to come up. And he's going to play his style playing guitar. Henrik! Henrik!
Thank you. tremendous honor to be here. It was really cool to watch the documentary last night. That was a fun party. And it's a true testament to what this man means to this community and to all of you. We really appreciate the opportunity to be able to play these awesome songs for you. Not all wonder are lost. This is what's called a room sucker room.
Tended ones to play a little bit, so we're gonna, you know, have a little. play some of these great songs, and we put our stamp on them. It's the better thing. So we'll just go ahead and play the songs.
This one is Shadow.
Thank you.
Now, Mike, can I get a little more of my guitar and my non-grade as well, please? So as we found out right before we played that the raffle, some of the raffles are going to be raffled off right after we're done. We've only got two more songs, so if you're going to buy raffle tickets, now is the time. I've got some. I'm going to win. Like, I'm very excited to win the football tickets. Don't put your tickets in the one with the football tickets.
going on and off means like 2 minutes from me. I don't know if y'all are keeping warm out there. We have an unofficial fifth member in our band named Johnny Five. And he's a propane tank. And he's hooked up to two things that generate heat when we use in the band practice, but he doesn't come to the shows for some reason. We can really use him tonight. Thanks again for asking us to be a part of this great event. Indeed. So that last song was Tender Like a Thorn. This next one is called Opium Den.
Yeah! Are you ready?
Dave, he writes dark songs.
Down.
All right, so we're canceled stamps. If you'd like to use some Maroon songs, please find us online. Raffle results coming up, and then more amazing music. And again, we're so grateful to be part of this today. So thanks, everyone.
We love you, Dave.
I just came here for my sleep.
guys for the music spin. All right, Dave, I think you wrote this song for me, man. This one's called Take Your Cover. I have no idea what it means, but it's fucking awesome. Some reason I just didn't feel right. I tried on a couple different things, trying to match my new purple shoes. And then I got here and I bought a Circle 9 and I'm wearing a black t-shirt and I feel just like I fucking should. But that's what I wear every day, is a black t-shirt. So I say, go get yourself a black t-shirt with a Circle 9 on it. And you too can feel like you're wearing what you should be. Or get a raffle ticket, or a CD, or something. Alright. Thank you, Dave, for bringing this all here. Yeah. I didn't do my homework, and I don't know the words to this song. So we're just going to flub our way through it, and we're going to get the fuck off the stage. Thank you. Thank you.
Chris said, Dave asked my brother and I, Jason, to work on his album, The Flood. Which is not out yet, hasn't been worked on yet, but we're gonna get it done one day. We're gonna get it out there. Alright, we got one more for you. This is called Elvis is God. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back. Linantud contains multitudes. Linantud, multitudes, I'm sure that's in a song somewhere. And I've spent a lot of time the past 3 months with these songs. By myself, staring in a mirror. And the great thing about Dave and Dave's songs is that they are poetic. I've taught a lot of poetry, and you know, once you kind of get past the motherfuckers and stuff, which, yeah, I know, which is how it happens. There's some really, really, really heartfelt stuff down there, and Dave has a vision of what he wants to do and how he wants to do it. And so I strongly recommend that if you're listening to the stuff, just put your earbuds in, don't do anything else, just listen to what he's talking about, and you're going to find some good stuff down there. Yeah.
Bones of a dog on the ground.
This is a true story. The first CD release show my band June Star had was at Wyatt's in 1999. And actually, it's probably 98, but whatever.
It was 98, Andy.
Now, Brian knows this.
Because it was my first gig with Circle M.
It's true. And Laura Linantud, wherever she is, she's out there somewhere. She had seen June Star play, and she said, "Oh, well, you know, my brother's band will play with you guys." And that's right.
They'll play with anybody.
Play with anybody.
I was like, I can't believe my luck. There's going to be a lot of people there. This is fantastic. And I said, we're playing at Wyatt's. And she said, oh, good, they can still play there. And I don't think I was paying close attention what was being said. So the night of the show, I'm hanging out with all those guys at the bar. Everyone's kind of drinking shots and having a good time, and we're talking about Steve Earle. And then Dave says, "Well, I guess we're gonna go play." So everyone goes up there to play, and I was like, "Oh, this is gonna be." I mean, it was great, but I was like, "Oh, it's gonna be great." And the first thing that comes out of his mouth is, "Well, it's a whole series of motherfuckers and stuff, and they're all directed at Brian."
100%.
And I'm sure their set was great, but all I could really focus on was all the things they were going to do to Brian after the show.
And they were done.
So I just want Brian to know that this is a stage space. I don't want you to be triggered. And I feel super fortunate to be able to play this song because this comes off of one of the many rock operas. This one is the, Spaceships, Boobies, Interstellar, Puncharama. Guns and Boobies. So this is Peace and Love, motherfuckers. Thank you. some motherfuckers. We don't get to say it as much as we want to. We love you, Dave Linantud. We love you, Dave Linantud. I love you, Dave Linantud. Disgusted. It ain't us against them. It's us against us. The spread against Rome. So you know everything. We'll be right back.
authenticity. You know, when people are really authentic and they are truly themselves, they inspire other people to be themselves. And I think that's what we're seeing here tonight. This is basically the house that Tude built. So we're gonna start off here. This first song is a really cool song. It's called Badass.
Don't be a child.